Page number six. I want to know more about my Lord.
I'm traveling through. out here, and one more time, the Lord's allowed me to come out of His house. That to be with His people, that to see and be unthankful for it. Many things could have happened today through this walkway of life, but the Lord seemed fit tonight to see me back here tonight. And He knows where my heart is. He certainly does. He knows that all about me tonight. There's nothing that's hidden that from the Lord tonight. It certainly is not. So I'm kind of expecting good things to happen tonight. And I really have. My heart's desire is, and we know Paul wrote in his writing that his heart desire was, Mike, to see Israel, that they might be saved. So that should be all of our desire tonight, that we see somebody saved tonight. Well, preacher, it's Wednesday night, and, well, I'm sure if we sung that song, and we usually sing around here, somebody's hand would go up on Wednesday night. So it's nothing for the Lord to save on Wednesday night. And we just got to get ourselves out of the way and just let the Lord do His work tonight. Amen. It certainly is. So I know there's several sick tonight and all this and that, but I feel pretty good in body tonight and feel pretty good in spirit tonight. I know there's some here with us tonight that's not feeling good, and the Lord will surely bless you for coming out this way. Certainly we can. I know the Lord has got a wonderful table set for us this evening. He certainly has. And if I don't ramble on and run it tonight, the Lord knows our hearts tonight. He certainly does. It's a good place for me to be tonight. It's a good place to come in now out of the world for just a little while.
Amen.
Just see what the Lord's got in store for you tonight. He certainly does. So it'll take us being willing.
Yeah.
Take us being obedient tonight. It certainly will.
Amen.
For that spirit to come. I know I sound like a broken record, but I'll tell you, somebody will hold the key to this hour.
That's
could be
it.
Just
Amen.
One word. Usually Jeremy says, I'm glad I'm saved. Amen. Sometimes that's all it takes.
Amen.
It certainly is. Just one word, and that from the heart. It's got to come from the depths of the heart. Amen. So it's a good place for me to be. And boy, it would be good to see you.
Amen.
Somebody say,
Amen.
Get up with that good smile on their face and that joy within their heart.
Amen.
Amen. I wonder if somebody got something on your heart. Song, testimony, something you want to do or say.
Marty, I have any requests. Like something to go for in here. I ask you to remember the family, the ones that got killed there. One of the boys, their son, he's in school. He's in the class of Christian. And, it was sad all over there.
Yeah.
Both they lost their mom and mom and stepdad, but the little 9-year-old, that was his mom and dad. And
sure.
I actually didn't remember that family because I don't know their situation. And
no.
From the talk I've heard out of him and his sister, I just don't know if they got anything or not. But
bless them all.
I thank God for being here. I thank God for watching over me over the weekend, watching over me while I was at the hospital and everything.
Yeah.
I thank God for that. But if it had been something else and it had went on, I'd been better off anyway. But I thank God for that. I thank God that I know that I don't have nothing to worry about. When I lay down to sleep at night, I know where I'm going if I don't wake up. I thank God for being here, and I thank God I know I'm saved.
Amen.
He just happened to call me for some reason and just asked me to remember his niece in prayer. I believe it was. So, Lord knows his heart. That's exactly what they need.
Amen. God bless you, Jeremy.
Mark says, give me safe.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes,
it is.
Here. But I'm praying every night. Also, I've got
Amen.
I just want to thank you for all my many blessings. Thank you for allowing me to be here tonight, and I just want to thank you for all y'all. It's all a big blessing to me just to hear all that y'all got to praise him for. It's a blessing just to hear it. I'm thankful that he allows me to be here to hear it.
Amen.
God bless you, John.
I'm sure everybody's experienced starting a new job. This is my second week. It's starting to get a little rough, and I said it's Wednesday. I know where I'm going. I can get through it. I can get to church.
Right.
But I'm still happy. I had to see by and pick up my husband. He was on our way.
Right.
I just made it worth the while.
Amen.
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 God bless your heart.
Amen.
You know, David said, let us be glad to go to the house of the Lord.
Yeah.
I'm not only thankful to be here tonight, but I'm thankful that I want to be here.
Amen.
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 Amen. God bless your heart. Bless you, John.
We got news this week that one of our friends' little girls got saved on Sunday, so
praise
I want to thank God.
Thank the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I'm thankful for the peaceful week that he's gave me so far. I thank God for the prayers that he's answered this week and the ones that he's going to answer this week. Ask y'all to remember Paige and Stephen.
Okay.
I know they're searching. And,
they are.
You know, I'm not saying they go to a dead church.
No.
But, we got a grandbaby that's asking a lot of questions, and it's going to be need to be saved before long.
Let
y'all remember them.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I want to thank you for all my many blessings. And
come on, Trey.
Just each and every day, and give us exactly what we need for that day.
Amen.
Marty, I got a song old Jeremy sang. It came to me a while ago when we got here before choir started. But you know, the song is, I know he sings a lot too, it's called The Old Church. You know, I thank God for our church.
Yeah.
And I thank God for being here. I thank God for the power and the spirit that's in this church.
Bless
him,
Lord.
My heart's about to beat out with you.
Oh,
I'm going to say it before you say it.
Come on.
I got to thank him just for letting me get here tonight, just to make it. Thank him for the peace that he put in my heart, the joy. And it happened on a Wednesday night.
Bless
him. Tell him it can happen anywhere, anytime.
Yeah, right.
And
amen.
I want to see it. Bless him. I'm ready to see it.
Yeah.
I just thank you for the desire in my heart to be here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bless
the Lord.
We get home,
so
we don't say, are we going to church? We say, you ready to go?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh,
ain't no one, I'm going and I'm ready to get there.
That's right.
Yeah.
And I thank you for all my blessings, most of all my salvation.
Thank the Lord.
You know, I'll just go show you, Paul. Ain't been saved that
long. Not
long
enough.
He just grace him, he got saved. God puts that desire in your heart to be in his house.
Yeah.
I don't understand how people just go from day to day and just say, well, I ain't going today because that's what to or whatever, you know. I thank God he said to me that I want to go to church. I want to be there. Just like you said, there's a desire that he puts there for his people to come together in one mind and one accord to help each other and to lift each other up.
Sister said something.
Come on, go
about what David said. David also said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
Amen.
He takes care of so many things in our lives.
Come on, Mike.
The little things.
Amen.
We just take for granted.
Yeah.
But God will never forsake his people.
Yeah.
I don't care if the whole world turns against you, God still be on your side. And the deciding factor is in God's favor.
That's right.
That's what the deciding factor is.
But
it's all said and done with smoke clears.
Come on, Mike.
When he calls his church home,
Amen.
Our war will be over.
It'll be over with.
Our war will be over.
Right.
Our fight will be
over.
Amen. Yeah.
We'll be there with the eternal tickets.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Before y'all sing this song, I'd just like to thank the Lord for his many, many blessings. Just allowing us to be able to be out here this night is a blessing in itself.
It is.
You know, I've got a song that I listen to, and I'm not going to sing it. I can't sing it. I don't know the words to it.
Bless him all.
It says, I can't even walk without him holding my hand.
Yeah.
You know, that's the truth. You know, I'll go even as far as to say, I can't even move without him holding my hand.
That's right.
If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be nothing but the dust of this earth. And I thank the Lord for his many blessings.
Bless him all.
I thank him for holding my hand when I cannot stand.
Amen.
His many blessings and all his grace he's shown it to me. I've been so undeserving of it.
I have to.
Bless
your heart.
Bless you know, Marty, I want to say one other thing, too, for Jeremy's sake. You know, I was thinking a lot about those, that family, the ones that died, you know, and got killed, Rick. You know, there's a lot of kids in class that I know that don't go to church. And there's a lot of them that the way they talk or everything, maybe this right here will show them something. You know, I pray that it does. I pray that it shows them what they need. Life is very fragile. You know, we can be, we may never even make it back home. That's how fragile life is. We need to live every single day that we can, telling each other how much we love one another. You know, people think I'm crazy whenever I told them before that me and Tiffany don't fight. You know, that's the thing about it is we I told her we purposed in our heart when we got married that we'd never going to be mad at each other. Or we never leave the house mad at each other because you never know if you'll ever make it back home or not.
Sure,
if you say something that hurts somebody and they die, then you're going to live with that.
Yeah.
You know, we need to be found every day telling people how much we love them and how much we care for them.
Yeah.
And not put people down and not try to destroy what they've got. Because we never know what's going to happen that day. And we may never make it home. I'm sure that when they're on their way home at night, they never even thought about not making it home.
True.
We need to think about that. And kids, I want you kids to listen to something right here. You need to realize how fragile life is.
Yeah.
Because you never know if you're going to make it home or if your mom and dad's going to make it home or nothing. We always need a purpose in our heart. We tell each other every day how much we love one another.
Yeah.
How much we think of each other. And I want this whole entire church to know, visitors, members, and all, how much I love you.
Yes,
and how much I appreciate you and what you mean to me.
Bless you all.
I remember well that old church mom and dad brought me a bit. All the faces of the ones that were there. And how those folks rejoiced when the Holy Ghost came down. That old church back in my hometown.
church like this might make for the mother church.
Yeah.
And for all as many blessings.
Yeah. Amen.
Yes, sir. God bless your heart. Aaron, come on.
Bless you, Lord.
Bless you, Lord.
It's a good time.
Yeah, amen.
Do this by myself.
No, we can't.
I can't. You men know that any time that you got to go somewhere, or any time that you proclaim God and His glory, the devil's right there.
Amen.
I mean, that's just how quick it is. I mean, as soon as you say or try to do something for the Lord, you better look out.
Yeah, amen.
I've been fighting the devil an awful lot here lately. Things going on in my life. There's nothing that I can do but to just trust God. And tonight, I guess that's about all I got to do. As I try to stand in that to proclaim His goodness, is just to trust God. Now, I don't really know what I'm going to do, or I don't really know what I'm going to say, but I'm going to trust God. He's helped me.
Amen.
I walk through life, and let me tell you what, He's going to take me on, and that one of these days, and I'm going to keep on trusting Him until that day of redemption. Let me tell you, I'm ready to go, and I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm just going to mind Him, but I fall about, as there's been people that's testified around the altar tonight how good it is to be in the house of God. Let me tell you what, it is a blessing to be and not one of these dead churches. The Bible says there is some that is twice better and plus another by the roots. Thanks be to God. There is a couple of churches that's got the power and the spirit in it. And I'm thankful for that church. The Bible tells me. Let me tell you what. The Bible says where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Thanks be to God. I've got a desire to be in the house of God. My treasure lies on the altar of God.
Yeah, come on, boy.
Amen. The Bible teaches me. Amen. The Bible teaches me to lay my treasure. Thanks be to God. It's none of this worldly junk. Amen. Let me tell you what. I've got a treasure that this world can't touch. I got it on the altar of God.
Amen.
That's what makes me want to come to the Lord. Amen. All right. I'm all right now. Amen. I just got a little bit of scripture. I don't know what I'm going to do with it. And that'll be just fine. If I read it and I sit down, I want you to know that I'm born again. And it's good to be in the house of God.
Amen.
Amen. That'll be all right. I want to be an encouragement to this church. Let me tell you what. Amen. I want you to read over here, Jeremiah. I don't want to get too far ahead. Amen. God has been so good to me. Oh, Lord. I don't know what I'd do without Him sometimes. He is so good. Through the stormy waters, thanks be to God, He made the water.
Amen.
All right. Here we go. A very familiar scripture. Amen. 29th chapter.
Come on.
This has been on my heart. Oh, Lord. Ever since, I guess, You called me to come. Amen. This has been on my heart. Oh, Lord. Oh, and the 10th verse. For thus saith the Lord, that after 70 years be accomplished at Babylon, I will visit you and perform my good word toward you and causing you to return to this place. For I know the thoughts. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Then shall you call upon me, and you shall go and pray to me, and I will hearken to you. That's all I got. Amen. I know it may have been short, and that'll be all right. But I want you to really think about this tonight, about how. What his thoughts are, and that toward you. Amen. He says that he has good thoughts, but as people as unworthy as you.
Come on,
Lord. Amen. Oh, Lord. As awful as I've treated him, Lord, down through this wall, I've treated him bad. Let me tell you what, I've done some awful things. But by God's grace and his mercy, he has good thoughts toward me.
Amen.
Oh, Lord, I want you to think about that. He was talking about. Oh, this was written by Jeremiah. And you can go and read the whole chapter if you want. It was a letter that was sent out to the people in captivity. Amen. All those people, Nebuchadnezzar, took them captive. They took them back to Babylon. Thanks be to God that he looked down upon a prophet and say, send this. There's some people that need help. Oh, Lord. Those people, amen, were in some bad shape. Amen. I think I may have preached on this before, if I think correct. Oh, Lord, I preached on that, being a love letter. Amen. Because those people were in such a shame. The devil, how easy it is for the devil to take us captive. I think there's no hope that we can't see the end. That we can't see the light at the end of a thanks be to God. Let me tell you what. He said that he was going to give us an expected end. Amen. I've got some expected end in my life.
Come on, boy.
He's blessed me.
Come on.
Be all
blessed. Amen. Amen.
Oh,
bless him, boy. Come on, boy.
Amen. Bless me.
Bless
me. I've got one expected in my life.
Come on.
Oh, that is as when I look at the eastern sky.
Come on.
Amen. This is Bible. When that sky splits, that will be the end.
Amen.
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 I believe.
Bless you, Lord.
Bless you, Father. Come on, Aaron.
I believe that that time is more closer than it's ever been.
Yeah,
God,
what do you think?
Close. God, be
close. Amen. Come on, Aaron.
Those people that were in captivity. Amen. Let me tell you what. It's in the Word.
Yeah.
He told them. He said, while you were in that land, he said, you just go ahead and build your houses, and you eat
come
in
on,
that
man.
Land.
Come on, man. Come on, boy.
Let me tell you what.
Come on, boy.
Hey, man, thanks be to God.
Come on.
He loved them people enough.
Amen.
But I said no word. I just said a little love for them.
Right.
Oh,
right.
Bless you, boy.
Yes.
Come on, boy.
Just a
little
love. Smile.
Yeah.
All right, back that's all right.
All right.
Amen. I want to get through this. It'll be all right.
Yes.
I'll try to take my time.
Bless you, Lord.
Hey, talks about them. And he said, go ahead out there in the captivity. Go ahead.
Yeah, come on.
And Mary. Go ahead.
Bless you, Lord.
Oh, Lord. Amen.
Come on,
Mary. Thanks be to God. He said that he would never leave us nor forsake us.
Amen.
Even until the end.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
Bless you, Lord.
Oh, there's an end coming. Oh, he's going to come back.
Amen. Come on, boy.
Oh. Lord, just to think about those people out there.
Bless you, Lord.
Kind of about like how I've been. Oh, Lord.
Yeah.
It's good enough for y'all. It's good enough for me. Good enough for the people back here. It's good enough for me.
Yes.
Help him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
When we get to the lowest state that we can think of.
Yes.
When the devil, amen.
Come on, boy.
Oh, Lord. When the devil gets a hold of us and drags us.
Come on.
To our lowest spot.
Right.
God's still there.
Amen.
He's still telling us, if you'll look to me.
Yes.
Bless him, Lord.
You look to me.
Come on, boy.
Bless him, Lord.
I'll give you a double portion.
Yes.
Come on, boy.
Amen.
Come on,
sir.
The Bible says, that they stayed in that land for 70 years.
Yes, it
more.
Bless him, Lord.
It's all right. Bless him, Lord. Amen.
Bless him, Lord.
Sure did.
Come no on. Doubt.
Come on, Aaron.
Following themselves a little pity party.
No doubt. No doubt.
I've been right, right there.
Yep.
Thinking, Lord, it's been 10 years now. Where are you at? God help, it'd been a day.
Yeah.
And I said, Lord, where are you at?
Yeah.
Little old 70 years.
Huh?
Yeah.
Don't you think that he had the people stay in the captivity to bring his son glory?
Bless you, Lord.
Bless you, Father.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Their prophets died in faith.
Bless him, Lord.
Huh?
Bless him, Lord.
That there was one that was coming.
Yeah.
Yes, they did.
Don't you think that he had them stay
bless
in that captivity? Don't you think when those sisters over at the tomb are saying, Lord, if you was just here.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, my brother.
If you was just here.
Yeah.
Oh, my brother wouldn't have lost his life.
Right.
Yeah. Little did they know.
Yeah.
Little did they know that there was a little bit of glory that was coming.
Come on.
There's so many times that we look at the things that happen our way, or it's no way.
Yeah. It's true. Come on, Eric. Bless him. Come on, boy.
And I'm right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm so blessed.
It's me.
Yeah, I'm good.
It's me, too.
Amen.
We like for things to happen our way.
That's right.
And give some kind of half-hearted prayer that don't get through the ceiling.
Right.
And the God. Oh, God.
Come on, boy.
We claim to get down on our knees and to try to get a hold of God.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
But half the time, it's God. God, give me this.
Yeah.
God, give me that.
Bless him.
Bless him.
Come on, boy.
the time it comes after. God, you do things according to your will, but I want this.
Yeah.
I want this to happen.
Bless you, Lord.
No doubt them people in captivity, I was in the same boat.
Yeah.
Come on, bless you, Paul.
Been there.
But thanks be to God, when we're in captivity, God still loves us.
Amen.
He still has thoughts.
Come on.
And the people is unworthy.
Amen.
Unrighteous. Amen. And they're just dirt. Oh, Lord.
Bless you, Lord.
Bless you, Lord. But thanks be to God. It goes on a little further.
Bless
him more. The Bible tells me that later said, when you seek him with your whole heart.
Right.
When you seek me and nothing else, then will I come.
Yes.
And turn away your captivity.
Bless him more.
Bless him more.
Bless him, Paul.
No doubt. We've got so many members in the Church of the Living God in captivity.
Yeah.
It ain't even funny.
Right.
True.
Amen.
True.
Amen.
And yet they come around the altar of God and think everything's okay.
Right.
And act like everything's okay.
Yeah, come on.
Bless him, Lord.
But you couldn't feel God if he was standing right there talking to you.
Bless him, Lord.
Amen.
Bless him,
Lord. Bless him, Lord.
God comes in.
Yeah.
The church.
Come on, brothers.
Come on, boy.
Through his comforter.
Yeah.
Come on. Excuse
me.
Come on.
And yet people sit around.
Come on, boy.
Yeah,
Sterling.
And don't do a thing in the world of
God. Right. Amen.
Bless him,
Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
I'll tell you this. If you just want to stay in your captive state, then stay there.
Bless him, Lord.
But I'll tell you this, right there's the door.
Bless
Amen.
You, Lord.
You ain't doing nothing but hindering the Church of the Living God.
Amen.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him,
Lord. Oh, Lord. I'll fight this.
Yeah.
We got people. God help me.
Come on.
Bless
come on,
we've got people. God, oh Lord. Going out their church doors and getting out in the world and doing every ungodly thing.
Yeah.
Come on.
Sure is.
Bless him, Lord.
And they're coming in the house of God.
Bless him, Lord.
Getting up on the altar of God. You may have us preachers full.
Right.
Yes. But your spirit, your countenance, it'll tell
Amen.
You.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Bless
the
Lord.
Bless
him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
We expect to come in God's house.
Bless him, Lord.
And see the real captive people.
Bless him,
Lord.
Get what they need.
Yeah.
You're lost.
Yeah.
God help no one.
Yeah.
I'll go this far.
Bless him more.
Bless him more, Eric.
Come on, brother.
Bless him.
I'll go this far.
Come on, brother.
Hey, man.
Bless him.
On the authority of God's word, we got people coming up here claiming to get right. They go back out the house of God and are right back in the same thing. There's so many times that only God will only put up with that so many times.
Amen.
You will get your attention.
Bless him, Lord.
checking on some salvation.
Amen. Come on, here.
Bless him, Lord.
Yeah.
We've got lost people, lost church members.
Yes.
He won't surprise me.
Bless him, Lord.
I won't know, obviously, but on his coming, how many church members end up in hell?
Right.
Yeah.
Amen.
So true.
That's true.
We've got so many captive people in our church, no wonder the church can't get free.
Yeah.
You ain't doing nothing but dragging it down. Hey, now listen, I love you all.
Yeah. Bless we love you, Lord. Lord.
That's all right.
Bless
yeah.
Lord.
Yeah. Yeah. We love you. I preach the truth, brother.
That's all right.
Yes.
I love you all.
Amen.
Yeah.
Bless you. I'm just trying to help.
Yeah.
That's right.
Bless you, Lord.
I'm going to go ahead and say it right now, the altar's open.
Yeah.
That'll be all right.
Yeah.
You let me and God work this thing out.
Yeah.
But the altar's already open.
Yes.
Yeah.
We've got
come on,
so many lost people in our church.
Yeah.
Come on.
Adults, little children.
Yeah. Come on.
And we act like we ain't got a care in the world.
Come on.
Yeah.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless
Drew.
Lost people, I want to encourage you tonight.
Bless him, Lord.
To regardless what the church does, whenever God comes by and he knocks on your heart's door, just come on down.
Yeah.
Amen. You don't get saved.
Yes.
Oh, Lord. You don't get saved by the church.
No,
you get saved through the church.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. Oh, we've got so many people going on some false salvation.
Yeah.
They're going to split hell wide open.
Amen.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Church member, it may be your daughter, it may be your son, it may be your husband, in some dire need, in some utter desolation, in need of some good old Holy Ghost. Oh, why don't you get yourself right?
Come
on to where you can pray for those people.
Amen.
Oh, you can open up your heart. And when God gives you liberty, you can say that something that might encourage them.
Yeah.
That might bring them down to an old fashioned altar.
Bless you, Lord. Come on.
Bless
him,
Lord.
We have so many people. Oh, Lord. It's so easy to point out everybody else.
Hey, yeah. There is.
Why don't we seek our own heart?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Yeah.
The Bible. God, hit me in a few more minutes. The Bible said that Jesus told Peter in some words.
Bless you, Lord.
He said, Satan desired you.
Mm-hmm.
I'd have sifted you as wheat.
Yes.
Hey, man. Hey, if those people over in the captivity of Babylon. If they was to just say God, I just say we ain't going with that, how the devil would have shifted them.
Right. Sure enough.
But thanks be to God. No doubt them people got tired down on their knees.
Yeah. Yeah.
Crying out for God Almighty to come by.
Yeah.
I had to give them peace.
Come on.
That passes all understanding.
Amen. Come on, Aaron.
You will.
Bless you, brother.
Oh, we got people who are sitting around in captivity.
Yeah.
I bet you tonight, I bet they're okay with what we're in. As long as you're in that state, as long as you're in that condition, in that mind and heart set, that you ain't going to do nothing, you ain't going to do nothing.
That's right.
But when you get tired of it, and God comes by, and He begins to deal with your heart, He's willing to turn you away from your captivity. You seek Him with your whole heart. There's been so many times that I've knelt, not knowing what to say or do. God will take that. A humble heart. The Bible says, exalt, oh Lord, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, and He'll exalt you.
In due time.
Amen.
Tonight, I beg you, we got lost people around the church. We've got lost church members. You may be sitting beside one of them. Why don't you come and get out of the captive state that you're in? The condition that is so easily to turn away from when God does it.
Amen.
I'll say that, when God does it. But you're holding on to something. You're holding on, no doubt, to some worldly junk. You're holding on to something that you love more than God.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy. A lot of people say, oh, God's number one in my life.
Yeah.
Amen, I do it. I do it. But yet, when it comes down, to me getting in that, I got to do this first. When it comes down to me praying, Lord, just hang on.
Yeah.
I ain't putting Him first.
That's
true.
Whatever it is that's between you and God, that's the thing that you love, that you put first.
Amen. Your God.
Amen.
I can't help you. I can't help you.
Yeah.
But I can guarantee you that God can.
Amen.
I guarantee you.
Amen.
If you're sitting there in a condition,
bless Him, Lord.
Thinking, Lord, what am I going to do? Mm-hmm. I've got this going wrong. I've got that going wrong.
Yeah.
Just bow your knees. Bow your heart to an Almighty God, and He'll help you.
Yeah. Amen.
We'll see lost people around this church saved. We'll see lost people around the nation saved.
Amen.
The Bible said, some like that He turned them away from all the nations. Let me see here. It'll be all right. It'll be all right. It'll take me a minute to find it. But I believe that tonight. I believe that He'll say, if America could get right, right in where they need to be with God, they wouldn't go a service. They no doubt they wouldn't go a day. Then we wouldn't hear about some people getting born again.
That's right.
It says, and I will be found of you, saith the Lord, and I will turn away your captivity, and I will gather you from all the nations and from all the places whither I have driven you. He'll drive you. You come up here seeking Him with your whole heart.
Yeah.
He will turn your life around.
Amen.
He will.
That's right. Amen.
He will turn you away from a direction. Anybody ever say one of them U-turn signs on the highway? Just something He showed me. He'll cause you to put your blinker on. I appreciate God helping me one more time. I know it ain't been much, and I know I'll fight the devil in a minute, but that'll be all right. You know, if you got something in your life that you want to get cleared up with God, right here's the altar. Lost person, I was once in your shoes.
Yeah. Me too.
You do the exact same thing that you see or supposed to see the adults around this place do. Some good old God-fearing people, men and women. You follow in their footsteps. And he'll turn you away. He'll turn you away from a devil's hell. He'll be calling your name. Oh, when that roll's called. He's going to call my name.
Come on, boy.
That'll be all right.
Amen. I'm awake.
You got something in your life right here's the altar.
Yes.
I beckon you earnestly.
Yes, I would.
And I believe there's somebody here that needs to pray.
Yes.
God didn't help me for no reason.
Exactly.
Somebody needs to find the altar tonight.
That's right.
It may be your last chance.
Yeah.
It's been said tonight.
Yeah.
Very
hard.
It's been said.
Yeah.
You may not make it home.
Amen.
You may not make it out them doors.
No.
Thanks be to God, you may drop dead in your seat.
Amen.
You'll just die in the condition that you're in. That's all I know.
That's it.
But I feel like somebody needs to pray tonight.
Well, bless you all, man. Well, you got a need tonight. Here's the altar. You hear the word, and it will not return void.
That's right. Amen.
Because he'll set out what it's accomplished to do.
Amen.
It is to help me and you. It is to help those that are lost that are seeking the Lord to find him. They find him at the worship. Bless you, Lord. If you need this altar tonight, it's open. It certainly is.